ready?
Baby.
Kay. Sentinels, welcome back to SCTV. We're your new anchors, Xenia Allo
and Adrian Chavez. Unfortunately, Brendan has been replaced. But now we have equality in the studio!
Yay!
On another happy note, we don't have school on Monday the 19th due to President's Day. Thank you to all of our presidents and everything that they have done for our country.
Especially my president, Mary Rose Fugger. Congrats to our Act Deck team for doing so well in the last event. They placed second in the Super Quiz Relay and sixth overall. Some people to note are Kayla Charles for taking bronze medal essay in the Scholastic Division, Michaela McNally for taking bronze and medal essay Honors Division, and Dylan Shipley for taking silver in math, gold in economics, gold in essay, music, and gold overall in the 10-event Scholastic Division. Great job, guys.
If you didn't get a chance to go see the play last weekend, you still have a chance. Go support your fellow Sentinels this weekend by seeing Kiss Me, Kate. And don't forget that you can get your house some points by bringing your ticket stub to your house later.
Congrats to our girls and boys basketball teams for both making it to playoffs. Go out and support them in their upcoming games.
And for all you seniors counting, only 87 days left until graduation. Don't let senioritis affect you too bad.
Spring sports are starting up. Baseball, softball, track and field, boys volleyball, and tennis. Make sure to talk to Mr. Mayo for information if you're interested in playing.
Boca Jeans is coming up next Thursday. Now let's go to Matt for more information on this.
Next Thursday, the 22nd of February. So the National Art Honor Society is going to be using the money to go to Michael's or Hobby Lobby and buy art supplies for a local elementary school in need of some art supplies.
All right, awesome.
So Buck of Jeans is a free dress day where you can come into my classroom, this is 102 here in the basement, and buy a wristband for $2, so you get to wear free dress for the day. You can wear, you know, just regular jeans, t-shirt, but remember no holes in the jeans, no yoga pants, and just make sure you follow all the guidelines in the handbook.
All right, thank you.
And here's Trevor for an in-depth look at the track and field team.
Thanks, guys. Track season has just started, and today we're going to interview some sprinters and the captains of the distance squad. We're here with Molly Carrasco and Roman DeCaro.
Quinn Burdick.
Beth Lopez.
And we're going to interview them.
I think we'll do pretty good against other competitors. I hope we all get number one in our races, and it should be fun getting a bunch of PRs throughout the season.
Yeah, it'll probably be pretty tough. There's always a lot of hard competition, but it's mostly about getting your own personal best, so that's really what matters, I'd say.
I think the competition will be pretty good this year. We didn't lose a lot of runners from last year, so we should be looking to make a big impact at state this year.
I think there's going to be some good teams. Hopefully our team does better than last year. We can always improve.
I think as a whole, we'll be really good, and then distance will be number one like we were like forever.
Yeah, hopefully we can get in like the top 10 at state or something. I mean, realistically, I don't think we can get number one, but we can try our best.
You know, I think the whole team will do great this year. Like I said, we didn't lose a lot of people from last year. We have a lot of returning runners that did very well last year at state, all throughout the year last year, and I think they're going to improve on their success from last year.
Yeah, I hope everyone that was here last year does better this year.
It's second semester, senior year, so.
Usually I just do my homework when I get home from practice. It's not too bad. We get home like 6:30, so it's not the worst.
It's just time management, really. You know, you just gotta grind out homework when you're not at track practice, because you know life's a grind and you gotta keep grinding.
Grind, don't stop.
They'll be pretty good. They have really fast runners like Mason Toyne and Kyle, but they're not going to be like distance because we're distance.
Yeah, I think they'll be pretty good. Hopefully they have some good freshmen that came out and hopefully they can compete well at state and get like in the top five or something like that.
Thank you for your time.
I think the distance team will be pretty good this year. You know, Coach Kent Nowak, you know, he's a great guy. Got some great runners on that team, so, you know, great team.
A lot of great distance people. Trevor's a distance runner. Lots of great people.
Thank you.
We're now a couple days into Lent, and I hope all you Sentinels are staying strong in your endeavors. Now let's go to Nick DeRose for more on this.
Hey, have you checked your calendars recently? It was just Ash Wednesday.
Oh, was it really?
Yeah, what are you giving up for Lent?
I think I'm gonna give up sweets.
Nice. I'm gonna give up using my phone a lot. I use it a lot.
Oh, she can use it less now?
Yeah.
Oh, that's good.
Yeah. All right, well, good afternoon, guys. I mean, it's good to see you, but what happened? Why are you here in detention with me today?
I was caught eating in the Fine Arts building.
It's fine.
Well, I got really mad at Cindy when she was in the camera shot and I yelled at her. Something working? Check. We're good? Okay, so the light. Why are you in the shot? Get out of the shot! I'm filming! Go! God.
I got caught texting in class.
Cindy, give me the phone. I can't believe you.
Well, welcome to detention. You know, it actually gives us a great chance to talk about Lent today. You know, so forcibly, you guys are giving up some of your time, but that whole idea of sacrifice is really what Lent is all about. You know, during Lent, the custom of giving something up is a very common practice. That it's a wonderful practice that so many people do. There's a great reason behind it. When we choose to give something up, whatever it might be, right, whatever we desire, whatever the Lord gives us in prayer to give up, what we're doing is we're recognizing, Lord, this thing that's in my life, this hobby or this food or whatever it is, this is good and I recognize the good. Does that make sense? That's what Lent is all about, this idea of sacrifice and voluntarily giving up something that's good because we desire God more.
Check. All right, we're ready, right? All right. Please watch out. We're filming.
Sorry.
Thank you.
Here's a few clips from the walkathon last week. Wait, it wasn't last week, was it?
It was 2 weeks ago.
Here's a few clips from the walkathon.
There's a message in the skies and in the streets. Opportunity. Stars, the arteries and veins that feed your heart. From the Dairy Queen to the head of the parade, in a blink your life could change. This could all be yours someday. This could all be yours someday. This could all.
good weekend. And if you didn't give up chocolate for Lent, don't forget to go get your discounted chocolate from Valentine's Day at your nearest Walgreens.
On the corner of happy and healthy.
Get out of the shot! I'm filming!
Brian, don't stop.